Hi there, I'm Chantelle with the Trace Keikis channel. Today's video is going to be a little bit more different. It's more of a vlog style without the makeup because today we're talking about skin cancer and skin cancer prevention. As you all know, I've been struggling with skin cancer for the last couple years. In fact, I just had a gnarly one removed here off my forehead a couple months ago. And my doctor has prescribed me Fluorouracil treatment. And maybe your doctor has prescribed it to you too, and you're just wondering, oh my gosh, what am I gonna look like? Can I go to work? Will my friends know? How bad is it gonna be? Well, it's okay, calm down. I have the answers. Or at least I'll show you what my journey looked like, and maybe you can know what to expect. After all, it's not every day that the pharmacist is the patient who actually wants to tell you what happened. For those of you who don't know what Fluorouracil is, it's a topical ointment aimed at preventing skin cancer. What it does is it goes in and attacks those precancerous cells and kills them first. I mean, treats them. So that they don't turn into tumors that you have to get cut off your face. So, you know, I'm up for that. For the purposes of this video, I only applied the Fluorouracil to half of my face for the 2-week treatment. I thought it'd be fun to have a more direct comparison and be your test subject. For the purposes of this video, I'm only gonna do half of my face right now. And since it's October and Halloween is around the corner, I thought it could be pretty funny if, you know, half of my face is blistering. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this on twice a day, morning and not too close to bedtime because you don't want it to get on your sheets. You want it to stay on your face and fully absorb. So twice a day for probably 8 to 12 weeks. Just kind of depends on how many blisters I get. So here we are at day one. You can see this picture. I have no makeup on and you can already see on the apple of my cheeks that there's some redness. Sometimes precancerous cells are mistaken for rosacea. Rosacea is people who have just red skin. But for me, I had these red blotchiness and my dermatologist thought they could be skin cancer or it could be rosacea. We'll find out when you put on Fluorouracil. By day three, you can see those rosacea looking areas starting to get redder. That means they're reacting to the treatment. By day 6 and 7, you can see the sensitive areas around my nose are starting to get red. The spots on my cheeks are getting redder. At this point, it doesn't hurt. You don't feel the stinging or anything. Maybe on the parts of my nose where it was red, it was a little bit sensitive, but at this point I could easily still put on concealer and go to work. Nobody knew. By the end of the first week, by day 8 and 9, you can see that the main cancer that was on my cheek has already started to heal and crest over, where the smaller cancers that are around my eye and my chin are beginning to blossom or get red. At this point, when I put on makeup to go to work, it kind of looked like I just had a little bit of an acne treatment. Still nobody knew, but my nose and my chin, they were starting to feel irritated pretty much all the time. In this case, I want you to know that it's fine to put on an ointment, but you need to put it on after the Fluorouracil treatment. So for me, it was mostly at night where it hurt after I washed my face and took the makeup off. The skin was pretty raw. So I would put on the Fluorouracil treatment and then put on some A&D ointment or some of my repair and relief ointment, anything that really soothed the area because it was just starting to sting. Now that we're at the point in the treatment that my skin cells are starting to react, let's talk about what's happening in real time on my face. First of all, every skin cell needs to reproduce every couple of weeks. Cancerous skin cells and precancerous skin cells, they reproduce at a much faster rate. And when any skin cell reproduces, it really needs to use this molecule or an ingredient called uracil. Uracil is specific to the DNA. So when it reproduces, it needs to use uracil. As you can hear, the name kind of sounds like Fluorouracil. So what that is Fluorouracil is like a Trojan horse. It's considered an anti-metabolite. So it looks like uracil, but it has a fluoride group attached to it. Our precancerous skin cells, they're reproducing really fast, so they're hungry all the time. When you put on the Fluorouracil, the precancerous skin cells, they gobble it up. And when it's time for them to reproduce, they can't because it's Fluorouracil. And instead of reproducing the DNA, it just explodes. Or bursts, which is why it's red. That's a good thing because it gives a chance for your normal skin cells to repopulate the area. So that's how it works. Day 10 through 14 was pretty much the same thing. One thing that my dermatologist said was that once the area has become inflamed, like around my nose and my mouth, and even on my lip. She said, it's done cooking. You don't need to put on the fluorouracil anymore. You just put it on until the redness appears, and then you're pretty much good. First of all, what is fluorouracil like? Well, it's a thick white cream that completely gets absorbed into the skin. For me, it took about 5 to 10 minutes for the medication and the oiliness of it to go away. I could definitely put on my makeup afterwards. That wasn't a problem. Putting it on before bed, you would want to give it at least a half hour before you lay down so it doesn't get all over your sheets. Aside from that, you're supposed to apply it every 12 hours, so in the morning and at night. If you're like me and you like to exercise in the morning, you can definitely apply it before you exercise, but you should wait 45 minutes before you sweat it all off. So I usually work out first, shower, then put it on, then put my makeup on. You can put sunscreen on over it. You can basically do anything you normally do with fluorouracil. By day 8 and 9 of the bigger parts, no. By day 8 and 9, you can see that the early, what do I wanna say? Okay, next up is a video that I shot on the last day of my 14-day treatment, and you can see how my skin looks with that. So I completed my fluorouracil treatment at 14 days of applying it, and you could see in the pictures that it was pretty inflamed, but I didn't blister, so that was great. It was just these red blotches. I did, however, have quite a bit of eczema around my nose and my mouth, and I've been using my eczema repair and relief lotion on there, and that's definitely helped with it because it's an ointment and it's non-stinging. But also the key thing is to keep that skin, that new skin that's coming in, to keep it moist. Otherwise, it too will just flake off and get dry. Next up are a few pictures of post-treatment. You can see that by day 6 of post-treatment, my skin looked a lot better. And it should, because the dead skin cells, the precancerous ones that were already inflamed, most of them have died and have been replaced. You might notice, though, that some still remain, even right now. Let me think, it has been about 4 weeks post-treatment, so after my 14-day treatment. You can see I still have some red spots up here especially. That's because fluorouracil is not a one-and-done treatment. It only gets a couple cells each time, and so you have to do it once a year. But the main thing to know is that the first time you do it is the worst. It gets better from there because you're killing more and more, and you're catching the newer ones sooner. Well, just like everything else in life, everybody's body is different. And if you're wondering how your face is gonna react to this, there's one thing that you can do first, and do a test treatment area. That's what I did. So I kinda knew what to expect. I did just a little 1-inch area, especially right here where I know I had a lot of sunspots. And just where I thought it would happen, there was a couple blisters, and that was it. And so that's pretty much what happened to the rest of my face, just a couple sporadic spots. If you do a test area and the whole thing reacts, then you know that's probably gonna happen to your whole face if you treat it as one unit. So I would suggest to you, if you have a really strong reaction to the test part, then maybe split it up. Maybe divide your face into 4 and do it every 2 weeks like that. It's a lot easier to manage, put makeup on, you won't have to take off work. It's a lot easier to explain to your friends instead of your entire face maybe looking like hamburger. But don't worry, like I said earlier, the first time is the worst. And if you don't do it, you're just gonna end up having surgery or skin grafts, or even worse, maybe like too much and you have to chop off your nose or your ear. So it's worth doing it. A couple blisters for 2 weeks is way better than a scar for life. Of course, prevention is key. It's just not worth having to go through all this. Please wear sunscreen. Please cover up. I can't stress this enough. My poor kids, I just attack them with sunscreen and hats and everything. I don't want this to happen to them. I don't want it to happen to you. So, with that in mind, learn from me. Take care. Bye. Thank you.